All right, parents hoping to pay for college often have to start saving even before their kids can even walk. Well, now as higher education costs skyrocket, some are rethinking long-held assumptions about college. Ryan Smith goes in-depth to look at how some people are recalculating the value of a degree.
Meet Eduardo Sanchez, a rising senior at Compton High School who's working this summer in the family business.
I'd rather be in school than this.
But this is one way he can afford to go to college like his three older brothers. Eduardo's father insists it's the only way for his sons to grab their fair share of the American dream.
He wants me to succeed, and he'll do whatever he has to do to be able to pay off my college.
But thousands of miles away from Eduardo and his family is another young adult who's been working in his family's business for years, but his takeaway is different. 18-year-old Carl Wesley Daniel, a recent high school grad whose Georgia family is begging him to go to college, has his own ideas about how to achieve his American dream.
I think college is an experience for certain people. It's for them being able to go and learn about life and learn about how to deal with people and deal with situations. And my whole life, I have been dealing with about every situation that has came to pass. And some people, it's really great for them. But for me, I feel that it wouldn't be sufficient as far as for me to be able to go and spend the money to go to school when I've already had the life experience.
The crisis facing Carl and a sea of seniors today is this question: is college really worth it? With the cost of tuition going way, way up and the employment rates of college grads plummeting, there's a growing movement that says college isn't always the answer. Even Eduardo, with his three college-educated brothers as role models, is seeing that a degree is no guarantee for healthy employment. He's seen it play out in real life, watching one of his college-educated brothers, an architect, struggle.
The second one, he's the one that he's having kind of like trouble working, but like he's always looking for jobs, trying to look for anything, any little thing to get money.
And money making is key here, especially if you do go to college, because for those giddy grads, most of them will leave college with a degree and on average about $24,000 in debt. So the question facing seniors and their parents is, at this rate, will going to college really pay off for everyone? It won't, say many experts, among them Dr. Robert Lerman. He thinks we need to rethink the way we view college.
Well, we have a very strong education-only bias. And so the educators look at academic skills mainly.
Lerman is pushing, among other things, an apprenticeship program that has worked in other countries.
An apprenticeship program is occupational training that comes in the form of work-based learning, and you actually have a job, you're earning money while you're learning at the workplace.
But other alternatives to overpriced schools might be community colleges, online courses, or even getting a job, like Eduardo and Carl. In the end, it might come down to the way those rising seniors and their parents rate the value of a college degree. If they think the bang of higher learning is worth all the big bucks they have to spend to get it. For Education Overtime, I'm Ryan Smith.